The Scrambled States of America by Lori Keller. Hi there, I'm Sam. I'm assuming since you opened this book that you're in the mood to hear a story. Well, you're in luck, because I have a story for you. This is a little story about this fine country of ours. At best you thought you'd heard them all, but not many people know this one. Let me tell it! Let me! No you two. That part is my job. Now get back in your places. We're about to start the story. Let's give them a couple of seconds to get back into position. 1001, 1002, 1003. Okay, turn the page. Well, it was just your basic, ordinary day in the good old USFA. States all over the country are waking up, having their first cups of coffee, reading the morning paper, and enjoying the beautiful sunrise. All the state says, except for Kansas, who is not feeling happy at all. How do I know this? Because he says, I'm not feeling happy at all. What's wrong? His best friend, Nebraska, kindly asked him. Nebraska is a very kind state. I don't know, moaned Kansas. I just feel bored. All day long we just sit here in the middle of the country. We never go anywhere, we never do anything, and we never meet any new states. Said Nebraska. Don't get me wrong, Nebraska, you're the best friend a state could have. But don't you ever want more? Don't you ever want to see what else is out there? Yes, I do, Nebraska says excitedly. And now that you mention it, I'm sick and tired of hearing North Dakota and South Dakota bicker all the time. I have a great idea, exclaimed Kansas. Let's have a party and invite all the other states. You know, one of those get-to-know-you deals. Everyone can bring their favorite dish. We call it music and dancing. That's a great idea, shrieked Nebraska. I wish I'd thought of it myself. So, with a little help from their neighbors, Missouri and Iowa, those wacky little Midwestern states planned the biggest party ever. They sent out invitations, they blew up balloons, they even hired a band to play. At last, the big day came, and little by little, the states arrived at the party. Nebraska and Kansas were on the welcoming committee, Iowa was in charge of coats, and Missouri and Illinois passed out name tags for each state to wear. Within minutes after their arrival, the states began making new friends with each other. It spent hours talking, laughing, dancing, and singing. It was long into the evening when Idaho and Virginia got up onto the stage. Excuse me, Idaho said politely. Idaho is a very polite state. Sorry to interrupt, but Virginia and I were just talking and we thought it might be fun if she and I switched places. You know, so we could see a new part of the country. Yes, Virginia chimed in. Then we thought maybe all of you might want to try it too. What do you think? A wave of excitement swept through the room. Oh yes! What a great idea! We should have done this years ago! They could hardly wait. Immediately, the states made their plans to switch places. They said their goodbyes and went directly home to pack. It took the better part of the next morning for the states to move through to new spots, but finally they were settled in. All of the states were much happier now that they were by the new neighbors and in a new part of the country. Oh yes, this was a much better arrangement. But after a couple of days had passed and all the excitement had died down, the states began to realize that they weren't as happy as they thought. Florida, who had switched spots to Minnesota, was freezing in the frosty northern climate. And Minnesota, who forgot to buy sunscreen, got an awful sunburn. Alabama, New York, and Indiana, all of whom took California's place, were bothered by annoying rumbling sounds that kept them up all night. Arizona, who had traded places with South Carolina, was upset because the ocean waves kept ruining her hairdo. Alaska, who will want to get a little more interaction with the other states, was irritated by Oklahoma's handle jabbing through his left side and Michigan's sun tickling his right. In Worcester Fall, Kansas, who has switched places with Hawaii because he was sick of being stuck in the middle of the country, was now stuck in the middle of nowhere, feeling lonesome and seasick. And Hawaii was longing for some peace and quiet of the good old days. Well, there was no question in any state's mind about what to do. Everyone wanted to go home. So, even faster than to make the first trip, they packed up their things and hit the road. As the sun set across the country, all of the states, from A to W, were back in their very own homes. The states were so happy to see their old friends again, and spent the entire evening sharing their new experiences with each other, the good and the bad. That night, all the states in the country went to bed feeling happy about the new friends they made, but most of all, feeling very thankful to be home. The Scrambled Season of America Talent Show by Lori Keller. Hello there, I'm Sam. Please pardon the mess. We're just cleaning up after the big... Wait, Uncle Sam, don't spoil it. You have to start from the beginning. Oh, I suppose you're right, you two. Well, okie dokie then. Take your seats, everyone. It's showtime. It all started quite simply, really. In the middle of the night, New York woke up in a dream and shouted, "Hey everyone, let's have a talent show!" Did someone say talent show? Well, that was unexpected. And quicker than you could say Star Spangled Banner, a talent show was underway. The states were so excited as they made their preparations. Some states playing solo acts and others playing group acts. Some preferred to use their talents behind the scenes. Indiana was the director, Arizona was the costume designer, and the number of states worked at stations, stamps, stage, lights, sound, and props. After a few days of blood, sweat, and tears, the states were ready for the big show. All the states, that is, except for Georgia. She was one of the Jolly Jugglers, along with California, Idaho, and Massachusetts. But every time they tried to rehearse, she started shaking so much she dropped everything she tried to juggle. "I'm worried about you, Georgia," Massachusetts said caringly. "Massachusetts is a very caring state. I think you should see the doctor." "I didn't know what's wrong with me," said Georgia. "I'll make an appointment." The next morning, Georgia told Dr. Globe all about her shaking, so he decided to run some tests. He checked her square miles, temperature, and average yearly rainfall. "Now I'd like you to take some x-rays. Don't worry, this won't hurt a bit," Dr. Glove assured her. "First, a close look at your cities. Now let's zoom out a bit and take a peek at your counties." Dr. Glove finished the exam and looked over the results. "Everything looks fine to me, Georgia. Tell me, is there anything unusual going on in your life?" "Well, I'm in the talent show tonight, and the words barely out of her mouth when suddenly she started shaking."
"That's it!"
cried Dr. Globe. "You've got a simple case of stage fright." "Stage fright?" asked Georgia. "Yes, it means you're nervous about performing in front of an audience."
"I am nervous, Doc,"
Georgia realized. "Is there any cure for stage fright?" "Well, the more you perform, the easier it gets. Over tonight, you should try picturing the audience in their underwear."
"What?"
Georgia squawked. "I know it sounds crazy, but it's supposed to seem the audience seem less scary. Give it a try." That night, the curtain opened to a bustling audience full of excited stage waiting to perform. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first ever Scrambled Stage Talent Show. I'm your host, Washington, D.C. By the way, does anyone know what D.C. stands for? Because I don't have a clue. Ha! yeah. Anyway, on with the show! Washington, D.C. introduced the first act of the evening, which happened to be the first stage himself, Delaware. Next came Kentucky, who sang while playing the banjo. Oregon, who sang while playing the organ. And Ohio, who sang while Delaware tried to gain control of his pogo stick. Michigan's ventriloquist acts as the winner. Who is doing the talking anyway? Minnesota's the Magnificent wowed the crowd with the help of his assistants. The station's gates kept the show rolling. Hawaii and Kansas performed the hula, Mississippi and Nevada danced the tango, and just before intermission, the new stage of the block brought the audience to their feet. It's intermission, so we'll be right back. I hope you're enjoying the show. Montana the Montanas kicks off the second half with their lively song and dance. Pennsylvania played the peppy tune of the Liberty Bell, but when his song went too long, Indiana the drummer started to panic. I'll take care of it, Oklahoma said confidently. Oklahoma is a very confident state. Alaska, the largest state, and Rhode Island, the smallest state, performed an act that had the audience at the edge of their seats. Iowa's corny jokes and Wisconsin's cheesy sculptures got the crowd laughing, and the state's impersonators had some rolling of the aisles. Well, the time had come for Georgia and the other jolly jugglers to take the stage. Georgia wasn't feeling particularly jolly. In fact, she never felt so scared in her life. We can do it, Massachusetts whispered as they stood behind the curtain. Georgia was just about to try doctor gloves when she heard Washington, D.C. say, Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage here our final act of the evening, the Jolly Jugglers, California, Georgia, Idaho, and At the very moment, Washington, D.C. got the whiff of Georgia's peach perfume and felt the sight of Alaska coming on. Massa! Just as his curtain started to rise, Washington, D.C. lets his arrow sneeze so big that it blew Massachusetts right off his feet. Massachusetts! Things seemed to move in slow motion as Massachusetts sailed through the air. In a panic, Indiana yelled to the jolly jugglers, Start juggling! Start juggling! So they did. Georgia had no time now for stage fright. She was worried sick about Massachusetts when suddenly, as she stood there juggling, he landed right in her hand. And as everyone in show business knows, if something unplanned happens, the show must go on. So she kept juggling, and stage warriors delight, even Georgia. The show was such a success that Washington, D.C. invited everyone up on stage for a celebration. Back at home, the stage chatted for hours about their big night. And even though Georgia didn't have to picture the audience in their underwear, she tried it anyway, just for fun.